Yeah. So what about glyphosate? We hear
glyphosate
all the time, right?
Been around since the 70s. Mm-hmm. Developed by Monsanto. Mm-hmm. John Franz discovered in 1970, came on the market in 1974. It is also a systemic, mm-hmm. non-selective herbicide. The phenoxies are somewhat selective in that they kill broadleaf weeds, right. or broadleaf plants, and they leave the grasses. Mm-hmm. That's why it's so good in lawns, right. so good in
grasses.
Pastures,
right.
and things like that. When Roundup, when glyphosate first came out under the trade name of Roundup, it was a non-selective herbicide. It killed anything you put it on. and it did that for a number of years. And then after a time, some weeds began to develop resistance mm-hmm. because it was used so much. And a little light bulb went off in somebody's head and said, if we have a weed that has resistance, maybe we can create crops that have resistance. So a brand spanking new yeah. technology was developed, Roundup Ready.
Yep.
Cotton, Roundup Ready soybeans, Roundup Ready corn, mm-hmm. plants. You could plant these crops and spray over the top, and it would kill every weed in that crop and leave the crop. And you may only have to do it a couple of times a year, mm-hmm. you know, one or two applications. So it drastically reduced the amount of herbicides that had to be applied to a field. It reduced the amount of tillage that had to be done. And but unfortunately, some of those weeds began to that were resistant began to crop up, and so we've had to go back and have to do things a little different. Now farmers have to use they've along the same lines they've come up with dicamba tolerant crops, mm-hmm. they've come up with 2,4-D tolerant crops, I'm sure there will be others as we go down the road.
Sure.
But farmers there's no longer a magic bullet. You
right.
know, farmers now have to use pre-emergent herbicides, and they have to target. It's kind of like, you know, we tell you to do a homeowner when you have an insect out there, identify what the insect is and then use what will kill that insect.
That's right.
or to control it if it needs controlling. It may not need controlling, you know. And glyphosate is one of the most widely used herbicides in the world, and still very widely used. The patent expired, I think, in 2000, and so there are a lot of generic glyphosates out there.
Okay.
And
but again, read the label on that.
Read the label. Labels are actually very interesting, and they tell you, you know, how to use the product, how to dispose of it, what to wear, how to be safe with it. Very, very interesting.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.